hello everyone, welcome to our Let's Play series of Underrail Expedition. This is Colonel RPG as usual, and I'm very happy that you chose to join me today, going in all the wrong directions, underground. We're always underground, it's Underrail after all. And I say you're going in all the wrong directions because we have a destination. Also, we have a room with no enemies. I'm surprised. I might be rushing a little bit in regards to my conclusion that there are no enemies in here. Rubber balls? Yeah, there are no enemies in here. At least that I can tell. So we have passages in here. A lot of them. Where is this going? So, we came from... Is that the entrance? That is the entrance, yeah. So we came straight up through here. And there's passages over there that lead to other places. And there's rocks over there. Let's go back, see if it leads to back to the place that I was just pointing at before. It looks like it does. Oh, yeah. So we went up on that one. And this leads downstairs again. I'm pretty sure it's to the same area that we have explored already. Thoroughly enough, it does indeed. In the lower passages, lower caverns, there's just a bunch of names for this map. And then there's that passage over there. Let's try this one. Because this might lead downstairs. It might lead to the same room that we were just in. It looks like that's the case. Let me just make sure. Why did I leave passage there? There's no more passage. That is the reason why I left passage, is because I hadn't gone up somewhere. I forgot, honestly. But anyway, that's fully explored, which is great. And we have that way. And I think that's our destination. Maybe. Let's go there. Because we never... No, I mean, we did come over here, because otherwise this wouldn't be discovered. But we never went this way. Okay. Oh, there's a dog. A normal dog. That's interesting. It's not a rat hound. Hello. Oh, dog sees me. Many dogs. And people. It's a lunatic. I remember this place. Okay, so... First things first. This hits them all. Sounds good to me. Second, let's try and get this dog over here. There we go. And the dog doesn't whine, which is good. And that actually... Oh, it does whine. And that actually hit... There's a chiller over there. That's gonna be a bit of a problem. do I have movement? I can't do that, can I? No, I can. I can. I have 17 action points. It's gonna take only 7. So... Ouch. And see what we can pull off. That guy needs to go around. That's actually quite good. We have a brawler, which is not good. The guy hits me for the first... that's just movement. That's not too bad. The health is too bad, but I think I'm gonna die. I think I am just gonna die. I'm gonna try and survive here, but if I do this, this is dead. This is death. Because then, if I come back, if there's no other way, yeah, we've learned that we shouldn't. There's no fleeing now. Also, we're dazed instead of stunned, which is good. Yeah. So yeah, that sort of solved the issue for me then. Yeah, let's go with a quick save. So yeah, you in this game since the patch, I suppose. No, I mean not necessarily the latest patch, but at least since I first played it, you can no longer flee. Oh, you can keep your stealth through different locations. That's good. You can no longer flee... Let's see... lunatics. Let's go with that. That's literally their their name. Their type of people. We don't need to go there, though. I wonder how I'm gonna... I just need to do a lot more damage than I do right now to be able to get past them. There's a rat hound. Should be able to do something with that. Nope. Hello. Nope. Rat hound sees me. Okay, they're getting into position, sort of. I mean, they are. So, let's try this. Let's try this. Yeah, that's safer than shooting myself. That's actually a tremendous amount of damage. Let's try this. And then let's fall back a little bit. Rat Hound is fleeing. That's the fire. Yeah, they don't like the fire. Fear. Yep. That's actually kind of good. Okay. See if I can catch up to the other one. I doubt it. Also, it's gonna catch up to me. Hello. Okay. So at least we're getting past these ones over here. This is indeed where we need to go anyway, so it's not a bad thing that we're here. Let's go ahead back in sneak mode. That looks like a... maybe a broken wall right there. And yes, the ice does blow that up, and it is kind of weird. So these rat hounds don't have anything for us. That thing, I'm pretty sure some of these are locked. That one is not locked. Also, it doesn't matter going in there. At least not for us. Hi. Hello. Oh, no. Oh, no. Ow. Well, that actually doesn't matter much. Because, that was a critical hit. This should have come the first time around. Because I regenerate. Isn't it lovely to have regeneration? It is. Okay. Remains for some hearts and whatnot. And some shotgun shells. Or casings. I think that was casings. And we have a locked thing over here. I am thinking it isn't pickable, though. Because it says locked. It doesn't say... No, it... Oh, nice. Another ID card over there. Very good. I don't know if it's supposed to... Does it? Is it supposed to tell me how much lockpicking it requires when I... try it? I don't remember. Let's see. We probably are not gonna use... Yeah, impossible. So the lock cannot be disabled, which means that I need to do... Oh, that's the SES soldiers. That's our friends. That guy wasn't doing much, though, because there were dogs all over. Now that is something that I might be able to get past. Lock picking. 30. Dang it. Wait. I have 33... Oh, it's base dexterity. Right. Yeah, I suck at that, don't I? Ah, well. Let's mark this as a lockpicking. 30. There it is. So that way I know. And we don't need to sneak anymore. That's not open. Oh, he has killed some of the dogs. Okay. So he's doing some work. Just not the work that I need him to do. Okay, let's try that again. Perfect. Hacking 25. Okay. I don't have batteries on this, which is fine. I have one. I have some batteries in here. Charge item. Like that, I suppose. That's a 30s. Yeah, it's pretty good. I still need to get a taser, and I think I should be able to make one, because I got the electro thingies. Oh, laser sight. Yeah, this game gives us a lot of laser sights later on. Those are actually only useful for a specific type of weapon. But they will still... Jack! Were you supposed to be here? Also, why is that door locked? Do you want to buy things? Hey. I was just about to leave. I honestly did not expect you should survive. You used me as a decoy. Not that I did. But it is as I promised. The man was waiting to pay you for the delivery. I never said who the man would be. He hands you the credits. Yeah, so we should survive the encounter we had before, a while back, actually. Was it a while back? Against those people who wanted the things. So why did you wait for me if you expected me to die? I'm a man of my word, Gary. I always honor the deal.
You would be honoring the deal forever if I had died. What will you do now?
I'll move on to some other place. The trains are out, but there are other ways to travel around, though. They are much slower. Especially if you don't know all the shortcuts. Let me know if there's something you'd like to trade before I leave.
Yeah. Please do. Please do. And we have a peak leatherness over here. Sell. Also, this is pretty important. I'd forgotten that they have, like, special deals for specific things. Speaking... The leather armors. Oh, yeah. It's That's specifically why... Yeah. So he doesn't buy anything except for this stuff. Except for... Well, he doesn't buy my stuff. Except for the specific things that he's asking for. So... What? Oh, right. Okay. So, yeah. I can carry that one. Let's get you something good. 400 and... Yeah. Let's sort this by... That way, so, yeah, 368, that's 412, so that's a little bit more money, I'll give you that. And that's the crossbows, but I don't have that many crossbows, do I? Nope, I only have that one. Okay. Okay, that's good enough. He has enough money to pay, which is great. I also have lockpicking Mark II, which I will buy? 5 of them? Sounds good to me. Omni tool over here, that's probably important. So I'll buy it as well. I remember using it for the ventilation shafts. Anything interesting around here? Just some other stuff that I don't really need. These don't give me agility. I kind of just wanted agility. Give me some agility, please, so I can get past that other place. I don't think I'll ever be able to get past that other place unless I, like, find the druggiest of drugs. Can you, how about... So, 100, that's 1,000. So, I would want... Okay. Oh! Oh, right. Because, yeah, I need to take 2 of these. Right there. Oh, and put that away. Right. And then I need to take... 1? I think? And we can trade. And he's not going to buy anything else. That's very good. Thank you. Okay. He's not leaving, though, so that's also interesting. Okay, so I want you right there. Omnitool goes right here. And you go right there. So we will be able to open that, because that's a +5, I think. Is it a +5? Could pick a lock up to 35. Wait, with the current one, it is a +5. Yeah, yeah. So we can come back and trade. He just needs 1 crossbow. Nothing else. No, I'm not carrying anything that's loaded. Well, I'll see you later, Jack. That mission is done. Did I actually get experience? I did get experience. Okay, let's open this thing. Now with our super lockpicks of lockpickness. Very 90s Mark II thing. Actually, 70s and 80s. The 90s. In the 90s, people didn't find the Mark II and III and things like that cool anymore, as they did before. Come on. Nothing here. Okay. But of course, this game has such huge inspiration from Fallout. And of course, probably the Stig is probably like 30 or 40 years old. So he grew up with Mark II things and whatnot. Hey, Mr. SGS. How's it going? I came here to talk about... they're expecting you inside, are they? Okay. Well, there's a passage over here, so I should probably... type it down. Although it's probably back to that other place that will kill me, so I don't like it as much. Lunatics. All caps. Oh, yeah, that's basically it. Let's go in here. So this is the main mission, the mission that we were sent to do over here. So we completed those 2, traveled to the GMS compound and talked to Gorsky. Complete tasks, Gorsky. Yeah, that's the one. Gorsky is in here. We got blood over there. Either that or red paint. And we got some things in here. Vial. A ventilation shaft that we can now look into. And if we want to open it, we need to use this. We can do it. Heck yeah. We can look into this one as well. Yeah, that doesn't get used. That's pretty cool. Yeah, I've forgotten about how exactly that worked. So there's a hacker over there hacking into that place, and Gorsky, let's have a chat with him. Sure took your time in getting here. Yeah, what is this place? This is the GMS compound. It used to belong to our old friends from Omega. They abandoned it at some point. Omega, whatever. Yeah, but not before sealing it shut, the bastards. We tried to break in a number of times, but it was no use. Now the earthquake has done the work for us. Oh, really? What does GMS stand for? I have no idea. But actually, SGS is Southgate Station, so the S is probably for station. I have no idea, but I doubt it was vital for their operations, as it was one of the first buildings they abandoned when their manpower started dwindling. Right, back to business. What is this place? Okay, I wanted to see what that question was, because I think I misread that question. Anyway, what's going on here, exactly? We're trying to break into that vault over there, but it's not going too well. What's so important about the vault? Well, according to an encrypted message we intercepted back during our war with Omega, there's reason to believe they sealed off something of value within this vault. Wait a second, I thought you said this place wasn't critical for them. Well, that doesn't mean it's not valuable. A dying man has no use for gold, but those who remain do. Anyway, I think they meant to reclaim it once the conflict was over. They lost, though, and it wasn't safe for them to be around here anymore, and maybe we killed the only man who knew how to open this blasted door. In any case, we need to get to the other side of that door. So what's going on here, exactly? We're trying to break into the vault over there. So how can I help? That's the one. I need you to find a way to open that door. There must be a security card somewhere with it which unlocks it. Your job is to find it. You might need to get to the lower to levels below. The elevator is out of commission because the place is running on auxiliary power, so be resourceful. Oh, I'm always resourceful. So I'm to go alone? What are the rest of you going to do, though? We'll continue trying to open the door manually. What, are you scared of a few rat hounds? Go get the bloody door open, you ninny.
You ninny? You ninny? He called me a ninny. I don't even know what that means.
I honestly don't. Because it could be... Is he calling me a coward? Is he calling me a weakling? Because those are different things. We have bottles. Yeah, I'll take all the things. And Omega ID cards. We're going to have way too many of those. Which is never a bad problem to have. We have some ventilation shafts that we can't open. Interestingly enough. Huh. We can open them from above. Shift 5 is easier. So, we can just peek or go through. Let's save before we go through, because you never know. Oh, also, yeah, considering there's blood splatters all over. Okay, and now we can open that for thoroughness, even though it's pointless. Yeah, and you can you go through? Yep. Locked on the other side. So we came from there. I think it's pretty obvious that we're going to be doing exploration based on the ventilation shafts. Okay. There's no passage over that way. So that sort of seals the deal in regards to exploring that bit over there. There's also this ventilation shaft that I think... Oh, there's three of them. And I don't think these connect to the same place over there. That requires lock picking. Let's see if we can avoid picking it. Let's go up in through there. Yep. That definitely connects to a different place. Oh! Oh, right. Okay, so it loops back around. So he just can't go over there and he can't open those. And these are also... It's a lot of noise over here because of the... What are they called? Ventilation? What are they called? Like because of the ventilation. We're in the ventilation shafts after all. Okay, this should be fine. Let's open that. So did we just buy... Did I just do the thing that I was supposed to do? Also, did I just go to the place where I was supposed to go? I think I did. So I was supposed to get the thing. The little screwdriver stuff that I'm using to open the ventilation shafts. And I got it. And I also was supposed to turn this on. So, we have auxiliary 1 and 2. That's for surveillance and for commons. Those are locked, though. And interesting that they are there, but you can't click on them. I like that. Auxiliary lights, I can... turn on the elevator. Huh. Can I... So, yeah, I can put the elevator over there. There it is. So, elevator and auxiliary lights. No surveillance system for me, thank you very much. This opens, so it wasn't really that much of a find. There's a rat hound over there. I'll worry about you in a little bit. We have some things in here. How's my carry weight right now? 111 out of 130. Gonna need to drop crap that we don't need. Okay. Oh, I wasn't supposed to get an Omni tool. I have one over here. Okay. Well, at least I got to congratulate myself, even though in hindsight I was wrong. It's fine. It's the act of self-congratulation that matters at the end of the day, isn't it? Nah, everybody knows that. So this food locker over here, is it 25? So that shouldn't be a problem there. Let's go ahead and open it. I don't know if that opens. Lock disabled. We have a pistol and a side booster. Good. I like the side boosters. I need those. Thank you. Also, we're gonna kill some hounds using the sinus. Oh, there's a many. There's a many. Oh, there's a many. This is bad news for everybody. That could go. I'm so bad at sneaking. Also, I got detected because they moved. Okay. So tricky clicking on them. I need to slow the time down. Okay. There you are. And time can be brought back up, even though you can't do it in combat, apparently. Let's try this one. They're afraid, at least. I didn't know that was gonna happen. Let's kill one. I didn't know you could make them afraid by simply shooting kind of close to them. That's very important against Red Hounds. Because that basically means that they're super easy to scare away at any moment. Okay, soon I'll be able to... kill them with one hit. Reliably, anyway. And here you are. Also, I know you're alone now. Good. And I can bring the speed back up. So we got a destroyed bot over here with some scraps and whatnot. Oh no, there's more! Oh, please don't hit me. You jerk. You are such the biggest of jerks. Was that a critical? That was not a critical. Yeah, I wrecked that guy. Okay. I'm still within regeneration range. And I'm still within sight range either, as well. So that's pretty good. Let's not venture too much farther. So we got a ventilation shaft over here leading to God knows where. Because it's like... There's a wall on the other side. Or rather... Yeah. So this is back over here. Getting all of them open is pretty important, so that at least I know where I've been and all that sort of stuff. Junk pile with some dirty rags. I really need to learn how to make bandages. Okay. Remains. And we found a fancy red hound ear. It's not fancy, just as a piercing or whatever. So let's see. Shift 5. But it is experience, though. The fancy red hound here. Also, we have the elevator operational, which means we can go downstairs. I'm just gonna open these. And hearing the dogs still, it's impossible to tell where they are, though. So it's not like, oh, they sound like they're going to the left or whatever. So that ventilation shaft is the way in there. I don't think it's directional, those sounds, is what I'm trying to say. Okay, so I think we're in the right spot. We don't need to open that and use one of our lockpicks. And we have a backpack in here with Omega ID card and also a key. You found this key in a locked room in the GMS level. Unfortunately, it doesn't work on that thing. Okay, let's get out through here. Did it say in the GMS level? That's a weird way of putting it. No, in GMS compound level 1. Yeah, I just misread it. Okay, and this goes elsewhere. Let's just go ahead and do that. It is great that my... Is it done? It is great that the Omni tool doesn't actually get used up. Because that's not my experience with the screwdrivers. They all get used up! because I'm terrible at using them, honestly. Because you need if you're tightening or untightening tight bolts, you oh, that's open. Sure, let's go. No, what? Oh, there's a dog. Interesting. If you're untightening tight bolts, you need to make. Oh, you missed. Nice. You need to make pressure downwards as well as, not sideways, I guess, but, you know, sort of rotationally. And the downwards pressure is hard to make. Okay, we got a ventilation, we got some shelves. We also have some over-encumbrance, which I should have no problem with, because these things suck, as we know. That one does not. So let's try and decompose some of that. Recycle item. I can recycle you. So, double-click. No, dang it. Can't recycle you. So, basically all the weapons are super expensive. It's a really good thing that we can see the prices. How about the steel combat knife? Is it very heavy? Yeah, this is kind of heavy. And I can't do anything with it. So, I'm just gonna drop it. In fact, I can just leave it over here. And we have another Omega ID card, which is great. So, let's go into here. And, no, that's not what I want. Just want to leave it over there. And that also sucks, so it leaves it over there. Although, then it does increase agility, so it doesn't suck at all. It's the best thing. That's the best thing. Now, this is pretty nasty, but it's not that heavy. I mean, it is kind of heavy, but it's nasty nonetheless. We have an adrenaline shot. Increases action points by 20. Oh, yeah, I remember using that quite a lot. Later in the game. It is kind of important. Also, did we get past that? I think we did. Because that one, yep, that requires hacking. Yeah, I don't need that. Let's see. So we have the ventilation shaft. That's why that other ventilation shaft is blocked. And we can just go out that way. And that way we have also explored everything. But this room, we haven't saved the game there, just in case. And also the key, I'm pretty sure the key is not for that thing. I'm looking for a card. We have a flare. We have some hypodermics thingies. We have a protectorate propaganda thingy. A hand grenade blueprint. And the surveillance room. I just got one experience from the key. I did get a blueprint for a sledgehammer. Some other things that are nice. I'm also over-encumbered. That's fine. Let's read about these ones over here. We're not going to be able to make them right now, but that's fine. Also, the Red Hound leather. That is not fine. Can I... Nope, I can't decompose that. What is the... Extract humor? No. I mean, yes, but... That's why I'm super over-encumbered. Actually, we could start looking into that. So right now, if I extract humor... Oh, I'm gonna need vials. So, yeah, that kind of sucks. Oh, wait. How am I... Was I... What happened there? Thought I was slow. Oh, the game got confused. Anyway, we're going downstairs, obviously. But before that, we are leveling up. Unless we get a new feat, which we do, which means that I'm not leveling up because I don't have my notes up on the left side of the screen. Or actually not left side of the screen, my left screen. I do have the end of the episode because we're out of time for the day. So for right now, I'm Colonel RPG and this has been Underrail Expedition. I really hope you've enjoyed it. And if you did, go ahead and leave a comment. Like the video if you want to see the next episode come out sooner rather than later. So far, you've been liking these videos so much that it's basically at one every day. And yeah, I'm very thankful for that. Thank you so much for joining me and for liking and for enjoying it. Hopefully you do. And I'll see you next episode. Bye-bye.